I mean, but we get tired, honey. We so tired. It's just, whoo, yeah. Praise him. Just give him all the glory. First, give it honor to God, who's the head of my life.
I get all it myself, and I feel like that is a very important thing when a woman is independent.
My mouth's a moist and the liquid is just going everywhere.
That's trigger points. Everybody has trigger points. Let's just be honest. Those are my trigger points.
Yoplait yogurt is like, I hit every single option possible. Baby, I did like baking. I think if you. Even though that's just a label. We're trans women, but we're still human at the end of the day. We want what everybody else wants, and that's just to be loved and accepted. That's all we damn want. Love and acceptance.
This is what we're going to do because I feel that I'm getting out of my character. So, this is what we're going to do.
It's time to be alive, isn't it?
My, how we came a long way.
All right, thank y'all for tuning in. Be sure, girl, this is my wig brush, y'all. Please, y'all know what's going on. Be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Most important button of them all is that subscribe button. It's free. Promote black business. I'm trying to say support. Now, why did it happen? That was the phone going and telling me it's on 20%. Baby, we got a second job. Congratulations. I'm trying to do so many things, girl. I'm trying to do so many things. And a second job was necessary. Please get on. Lord, look at the time. You got to get out of here, baby. Go on now. Oh, magic and mink having kids. What was I saying? I'm trying to do some things, you know, a little around the yard, around the house. And that's going to require money. And I have one job. Had one job. I had to go on and get a second source of income. I ain't taking my wig off camera. I might take it off from camera one day. I was taking my perm, honey. But girl, I had to, Lord, I'm so tired, child. Jesus, help me. Jesus, be a biscuit. He'll lock you up. He'll lock you up. I have things. This is horrible. I have things I'm trying to do. And that's gonna require some money. Okay, honey? And I ain't gonna just, I'm just throwing like this hell to hell with this shit. Y'all know what's going on. And I have to, I'm the kind of person, when I want something, I'd rather just go ahead and work for it. Just, cause I'm very prideful. I hate to ask for anything. I'd rather go ahead and just give it. And you respect it more, like you, appreciate it, you cherish it. But I'm gonna go ahead and start moving this paint. I just wanted to go ahead on and have an open conversation. Like, cause you never know who's watching. People be watching my little YouTube channel, and I'm honored, cause I'm, in my eyes, I'm just a regular old smuggler. I'm just Maya Ray, honey. I'm just a old trans girl from the country. Getting in front of the camera, talking noise, you know, just expressing myself and sharing my experiences and letting people in my life. So, I really appreciate y'all for just watching Little Boring Me. Yeah, I think I'm exciting, and I appreciate that, honey. But, working at a gas station, and now I have a second job. I work at a fast food restaurant, which I thought I would never be doing. Baby, they say never say never. You said they came back on. If this fall off on camera, I don't even care. I'm so tired. I got blonde at the top. Shit, I don't care. I'm tired. I really don't. But, so I work at the fast food restaurant, y'all. And if you follow me on social media, you already know which one I'm talking about. And today was my second day. It was only my second day. And I have to be honest, I freaking love it. Like, the job itself, the job responsibilities are extremely easy. Like, not trying to talk down on the people that work at Taco Bell, because I work, oh shit, I'm gonna say the damn name. Owen, that's how I talk. Not trying to talk down on the people that work there, but it's a real easy job. And I love an easy job. You know, we keep the store clean, give people their orders, send them on about their day. And that's it, you know? And you get paid a decent hourly rate. I love that. Then there's gas station where you get paid that same rate, in some cases a little cheaper, I mean a little below that rate, but the job responsibilities are so much more, they require so much more energy. And don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to complain. I'm just talking, like, I feel like I can talk to y'all. Y'all subscribe to me, y'all know I just want to talk to y'all. Don't say nothing I say personal. This is us talking. We just talking. This is the thing. This is the thing now. Nobody get offended. And nobody don't take it the wrong way. I might be complaining, but I'm just talking. I'm venting. We're friends here. We're all friends. We're family. We all it. We are a family like a giant tree. Reaching out to the sky. But I like working at the fast food restaurant better than the gas station. And I've been at the gas station for 6 months. Over 5 months. Below 6 months, over 5 months. So it's about to be 6 months. But I'm going to still work at the gas stations because, like I said earlier, I have things to do. And the gas station is definitely my number one job because, even though it's not my favorite, it's the one that gives me the most hours. You get what I'm saying? That's the money. Can't mess up the money. So I'm going to still work there. And like I said, it's just my second day at the fast food restaurant. But I can honestly say even the customers are so easier to deal with. Like, you know, we get our rude customers, but you got to think about it. It's fast food. So people really just come in to get their food, they gone. People come to the gas stations, they want to... God, bring their kids with no shoes on and just very ratchet and very ghetto. They want to argue with you when you ask them for their ID. They take everything personal. Oh my goodness. Then you see the same people every day, y'all. God damn. A hundred damn people, but no excitement. Now, on Friday nights and Saturday nights, you might see a little eye candy, but hell. That I can't be worth the damn, because they be coming in there getting $2 on pump four and all that. If you want to get $2, you know you can't be no eye candy. Well, you can be eye candy, but you ain't the good eye candy, you know. Not all candy is good for you. Well, this is what I'm playing. Working at the, oh my God, a good all in my eye, girl. Working at the gas station and working at the fast food restaurant, it works out perfectly for me because I work at 1 a.m, then I work at the other at night. So my schedules don't conflict with one another, and I love that. And I'm very appreciative of my managers at both jobs to even allow that to happen. Because, you know, I had to talk with both of them so everybody can be on the same page. We all can be knowing what's the tea and what ain't the tea and how much sugar to put in there, because we don't want no conflict of interest. I still have a life at the end of the day, you know. Mm-hmm. Damn, y'all. Okay, skin is very clear now. Skin is very clear. She's very soft and feminine and all the things to be. The things of all things, honey. Yeah, I really like that fast food job. I think I'm going to stay there as long as I can. Same with the gas station. I don't like it. To be honest. But I'm going to stay there as long as I can until I get rid of it. But the thing at the gas station, they be nitpicking a lot, too. Like, the certain things I do, I get in trouble. But if someone else do it, nobody says nothing, so, you know how that goes. Everybody had that kind of jobs, right? And I'm going to just go ahead and be honest about all my jobs. or at least the ones I feel like talking about, my favorite job I ever had is two of them. Home Depot. I worked at Home Depot. And my other favorite job was working at Racetrack. I worked at Racetrack. I loved going to Racetrack because Racetrack was easy too. Racetrack was easy. Racetrack was organized. And a lot of the stuff at this gas station I work at, we didn't have to do that Racetrack. Like, damn, like, wait a minute. Like, counting cigarettes and stuff, we didn't have to do that. That was the manager's job. And I think we got paid more working at Racetrack. I love Racetrack. And my favorite thing about a job is an organized schedule. The job I'm at now, they literally make the schedule weekly. They make a weekly schedule. Like, you don't know what you're working in 2 weeks. Which I hate because it's hard to plan your life. Like, yes, this is a job, but honey, we got lives. Well, at least I got lives. I got a life. This ain't my job. This ain't my life. This is my job. J-O-B. Not L-I-F-E. Come on now. But yeah, and then Racetrack, I had a set schedule. Literally, I miss Racetrack. But I had to leave Racetrack because by me being trans, it was a situation that it was almost an altercation with me and a coworker behind doing outside trash. Because, you know, we do switch. If you ever worked at Racetrack, you know what I'm talking about. They do like a store walk at the end of everybody's shift. And they write down what you're supposed to do. So prior to my arrival, someone was supposed to do outside trash. No one did it. So they was like, well, Maya, you can do it. I said, no, you know, because that's the way we do it. Let's not change it now because I'm here. The person who's getting ready to leave is supposed to do outside trash. You know, I'm not putting it on there. I'm going to do outside trash before I leave. They was like, oh, well, you're the man. I'm the who, bitch. You know, I had to get with that hoe. Girl, and that, you know, we all have trigger points. You know, we talk about trigger points on this channel. How fucking dare her to make her top and bottom lip move and let they come out? I had to book that hoe for next weekend trip in Paris. I had to let her know, stop room right there. No. Because if we're really talking about it, I'm presenting myself more womanly than you are because you come in here with your black lips and your ghetto posture and your ghetto mentality and stuff. Girl, that's why I don't fool with too many cis women because they love you to death until it's time to do like something and then the first thing they want to holler, well, you're a man. Look, I'm not asking everybody to agree with my lifestyle. I don't give a damn, but just don't disrespect me. That's all I'm saying. Don't be disrespectful because not one person on this earth can say Maya Ray was disrespectful to me immediately. Like, my disrespect comes as a response. When I get disrespectful, it's always a response to something. I don't just walk around being disrespectful to people. Life is too short. And that's such a nasty habit. Girl. And I don't take myself too serious. I'm on camera taking my makeup off. Like, I'm very confident. I know my skin isn't the best. I love it, though. It's me, you know. The hair ain't the longest, but hey, this is my hair. Like, I don't take myself that serious. I feel like I'm a queen. I go by Queen Bee. I'm a beautiful black trans woman, but I don't take myself too serious. And what I mean by that is I can walk into a store with no makeup just like this, and I still would care myself the way I would care myself with lashes and a wig on because this, to me, is not dress up. I'm not playing dress. This is who I am. You know, I'm just like any other biological woman or trans woman. Like, people feel as, because I'm trans, I need to be dressed up and have a beat face every time I walk out the house. You a lie. Number one, I ain't got time. Hell, when you walk out the house every day, do you be having a beat face? And even if you do, kudos to you. That's good, girl. But I ain't doing it not every day. I only do my makeup when I'm in the mood. And that is true tea, honey. Because when you really do makeup right, I ain't no perfectionist nothing. But, you know, come on, let's be honest. You can tell when you take your time, when you just throw it on. I ain't going to just put no makeup on. Just put it on. I go to work just like this. No, I won't. You got to look presentable at least. You're not like put the wig on. But if I don't want to wear no makeup, I wouldn't wear it. It's not necessary to wear makeup every day. To me, because as you can see, you got to wipe all that off, honey. I do not like going to sleep in makeup. Only when I'm drunk or I'm staying by a man's house. So, that's the only time you have makeup on my face. And I don't like staying by their house because it'll be all over their pillowcase. Because I'm a chocolate girl, so my foundation is chocolate. You hear what I'm saying and see what I'm saying to you. But yeah, girl. Like I said, I'm just talking. Huh? This is just me. This is what I do on my channel. I just talk. I kind of vent to the phone. And then I upload it. And then I upload it so everybody can watch Maya in her bathroom. Peeling off her layers. And just talking. What are we talking about? Working. Two jobs. As a trans woman in, should I say Avon? Y'all know where I'm at, Avon, Louisiana. How is it? Oh my God, did I talk about the customers already? The customer at the gas station, the customers at the gas station are so much worse. So much worse than the customers at the fast food restaurant. So much worse. Like the only thing with the customers at the restaurant, they're picky eaters, which is understandable. Cause I'm a picky eater. So, you know, I can't quite know I've been a picky eater. But at the gas station, they get mad. They feel like they own you. Like, earlier I told someone that their child had to have shoes on to walk in the store, which that's store policy. At least that's what was told to me from the big dog. She said, well, I don't see any sign that says no shoes, no shirt, no service. So I just kind of said, well, ma'am, you know, I just feel like it's common sense. You don't want your child walking into a public store with no shoes on, no socks. Well, the little child had socks on, they were filthy. Like, girl, I said, you got shoes on, put some shoes on that baby. That's horrible. Oh, girl, it's just and I'd be so depressed. Yeah, I deal with depression and anxiety. I deal with that every day. That's not something I just deal with once a week or something like that. I deal with depression every day, every single day. But I take my anxiety and depression pills faithfully. And today was actually a really messed up day for me. And it wasn't that no one messed it up. It was just one of those days. You know, you have those days where you're not feeling it. I wasn't feeling it today. You can't tell that I wasn't feeling it because at both jobs, I was the happiest one there. And that's what I tell people, like, I'm not one of those people that you're not gonna know that I'm upset. Unless I want you to know. Like, I don't believe in bringing all that and taking all that frustration and anger out on people. Like, it's not their fault. Number one, it's not, just stop. That's such an ugly trait to me. Like, you over here lashing out on everybody because you having a bad fucking day. Don't do that. And I live by that. Like, I have bad days a lot, but you bitches ain't gonna know it. Now I gotta run this bathwater, honey, get this coochie clean. I get that coochie clean. If your sex game mean, get that coochie clean. But I personally feel like if I can have two jobs as a black trans woman, come on, girls, y'all can have some too. Ooh, my booty hurt. I was picking up something early and I hit it, y'all, and I'm hurting. And I don't know, y'all, this is only my second day at the fast food restaurant. But I go to both of them at the same time. Like, the same day, I am exhausted. My pants was pulled all the way up, you know, because I suck all this in. But maybe I walked in the door like this. I'm tired. And I have to get up early in the morning and get these fixed. I like to go, like, as soon as they open, I got to go super early. Like, we got to do something about this. We have to do something about this. I'm about to have some bomb sleep. Go on, put a little bleach in this tub and take a bath. A friend girl told me about taking a bath and bleach. I'm going to try that because I talked to a few people. They said they do it too. I'm going to go and put a little bleach in the water. I never done it. But I'm about to do it tonight. See, I was wondering, like, does it lighten your skin? Does it mess up your pH balance? Like, what does it do? Put bleach in the water. Talk to me. I talk to you. Like, let me know. What's the deal? Y'all, I don't know what's going on. I'm so depressed. I'm so sorry if I'm everywhere. I feel like I'm everywhere, but hey, oh well, it happens. I'm gonna still upload this video because I think it's cute, and it's me. You know, you're on Myra Gavinsburg YouTube channel. You're gonna get different sides of me. This is my depressed side. I'm a little goofy when I'm depressed. I'm goofy when I'm not depressed, but I'm even goofier when I am depressed because it keeps my mind occupied. And like, well, what you depressed from? Bitch, life is hard, ho. Life is hard. Gosh. Especially hard. And I'm not going to, when I always bring up trans, I always talk about me being trans in anything and everything I do because nobody else talks about it. In this, especially in this small ass community, nobody talks about it. So I pride myself, girl, you always talk about being trans. I do, and I'm gonna continue to. I don't say anything y'all get on Facebook and y'all always talk about Black Lives Matter, which they do, but y'all always talk about it. So I'm always talking about how trans lives matter as well, especially Black trans lives. I'm gonna talk about that too. I always talk about being trans, that's what I do. That's me. I'm IRA. I am a trans woman and I wear it well. So what I say, I like to say, I'm not trying to sound like I'm using that as a handicap, because being trans isn't a handicap, but it definitely comes with a lot of struggles, trials, and tribulations in this shit we call fucking life. Shit, them bitches call me a fucking man. God damn it, bitch. I put that fucking voodoo on me. Glitter all in my damn eyes. They come to their gas station calling me all kind of fucking mans and punks and fags and all. I just want to get my video taken down. They call me all these derogatory words. And what upsets me is this. When I respond to their nasty, trifling, lowdown, dirty ass, I'm the problem. Like, what? Somebody, I ain't gonna say no names. I'm just gonna. Somebody even told me, none of this happened before you started working here. You raggedy bitch, probably because y'all never had a trans that worked there, girl. I never felt like I hate feeling like I have to get punished for taking up for myself. Bitch, if you took up for me, I probably wouldn't have to take up for myself. But knowing me, I would still do it, because I bet you one thing, I'm a whole lot of things, but a punk ain't one, bitch. A punk is a coward. Look up the definition, girl or boy, whoever's watching this, whoever's listening. I'm a lot of things, but I'm definitely not no coward. I will always and forever stand up for Maya Rae Gavinsburg, because guess what? Not no bitch walking this earth gonna do it. So I'm gonna always do it. Know that before you even get to respond, honey, them words coming out. Always stand my ground, because only one or two things gonna happen. Bitch, either you gonna tumble or I'm gonna tumble, but one of us gonna fucking tumble. And it's not over until we rumble. Let's get ready to rumble, you raggedy bitch. No, you ain't gonna come here and disrespect me. And then this is what really makes me mad. Then they be the ones that disrespect me. Then they want to come in there by my stuff at the gas station, come flirting all in my mouth. Get your raggedy ass in my face, bitch. You ain't even got enough to buy this 98-cent cold drink. Get your girlfriend keys and go crank up your car and drive home and scramble some eggs for her, because I'm sure she's hungry. In my face. My pretty face. I ain't put it on yet. Y'all, this is my friend girl, Kimmy. She makes this lotion. I'm put some of this on. She said, now look, you know, she said it's supposed to keep you moist all night, but I've been putting on while I took this makeup on. I be getting a little stuff on my lip. Now, Kim, I don't know what that's about. I do you there for, I don't know what that be. And it's only when I put this on, but I'm gonna go ahead and put it on. Kim, no, I'm honest with her. I love Kim. I love Kim products. I really do. Because one thing about if I ain't love it, I won't be putting it in my face. Maybe it'd be me drooling, because baby, my bed is really comfortable. I love sleeping by myself most nights. Because I just be sleeping good, honey. Good in the neighborhood. I'm somebody, somebody. Ain't nobody's gonna hold me down. I'm somebody. Let me go, y'all. I want to take off my clothes and, you know, get ready, but I'm on camera. And I only take off my clothes on camera for OnlyFans. Feel free to connect with me on social media and get the link to OnlyFans. All right, y'all. Thank y'all for tuning in. Hopefully, I keep y'all entertained. I try. I do try. I really do try to be. Sometimes I don't try. I just be talking like I did tonight. With a sprinkle of trying. You know, I did try a little bit. I'm in so much pain. I'm tired. Like, my buttocks hurt. I haven't had sex in 3 weeks. That's so random. I haven't had sex in 3 weeks. One more week will be a month. I've been promising some people I'm not gonna have sex for a month. Not no like relationship thing. It's just I can go a month without sex. You know, I think I'm gonna even go 2 months. Let's start slow. So I'm gonna go this 1 month and, you know, get back in the groove. Yes, honey. Be sure to like. Be sure to like, share, subscribe, comment. Tell a friend who's going to tell another friend who just happens to be a whore. You see all my feminine products. Bitch, turn this shit around. You see them feminine products, ho. And I see y'all on social media saying you got all them products. Your pussy must say, no, bitch. I give people options. I don't know how I want to smell. And I don't know how they want me to smell for that night. So I have flavors. I have flowers and fruit. And for my vegan men and stuff, I have vegetables and stuff I can smell. I smell like broccoli, honey. Clean broccoli. Freshly washed broccoli. Listen. Ooh. Oh, I got the Taco Bell on the table. Let me go eat. I'm eat before I take a... Oh, should I take a bath first? I'm going to take a bath first so everything can go on here to get tenderized and caramelized and seasoned and sautéed and get all this chicken oiled up, honey. You know, I always refer to myself as that juicy piece of chicken. You know, you get a box of chicken, you go for the juicy piece. That's me, girl. I really do love y'all for watching me, y'all. And I'm just going to be honest with y'all. Some people don't like when I just ramble on. And that's totally fine, you know. I'm just being me. I'm a random, goofy, kind of weird person. So this is what I do. I do appreciate y'all for tuning in, though. This has been Myra Production. A Myra Production. I always wanted to say that. Yeah. I the bitch. Okay, now I'm just talking shit. Bye, y'all. Damn, did I stop it?